It's the coldest hand to run down this land where the ocean lands. It's the tallest sound, the damn smallest crowd, but the hearts break loud. Far from ever feeling lost with me, I'll push you back towards land and sea. They're going down for love, and love is free. Stick with me, and I will guarantee you're never lost among the crowd with me. Never lost among the crowd with me. Everywhere you go, I'll be. Anywhere you go, I'll see. You're never lost among the crowd with me. It's the furthest sun, the gun done for love. It's a pulse and shove. It's the sharpest cry, the heat goes bit wide, where the desperate lie. Everywhere you go, I'll be. Anywhere you go, I'll see.
To share all joy, to be one with each other. Throughout history, men and women have sought to recognize the great moments in their lives. One of these occasions, they called first upon family and friends to share their joy and happiness. Because of the seriousness and beauty of such moments, they also have chosen to hold up these experiences before God, the Creator, creative power that brings together all people. Therefore, in the beauty of this setting, Mark and Lauren invite you to help celebrate their love and their marriage, and they wish to extend their gratitude to each of you for helping to make this day a cherished memory for them. During our time together, Mark and Lauren expressed how much your love and support means to them. When they were infants, you showed them the meaning of true love. When they were children, you taught them to walk in the world around them. As they grew older, you called on them to work hard for what they believed in. Now, as adults, they continue to draw on the inspiration and examples you have provided them. Mark and Lauren, thank you and recognize your presence today to communicate your enthusiasm for the decision to marry. And I personally would like to thank you for your presence, for I can attest to the fact that a marriage not only unites two people, but it also brings families together. With all my heart, I say thank you. You may be seated. O God, who alone unites persons in holy bonds of covenant, without whose spirit there is no abiding unity, be present in the inner being of Mark and Lauren, whose desire to be married, and among these whose sacred responsibility it is to give or withhold approval in the spirit of Christ the Lord. Amen.
Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put away the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only reflections in the mirror, then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. Now these three remain, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love.
Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit to yourselves, submit yourselves to your own husbands as you do to the Lord. The husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing of water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated their own body, but they feed and care for their body, just as Christ does the church, for we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you also must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband.
Mark and Lauren, I have to tell you, it's been an honor and a privilege to get to know you in the past several months. After all we've been through together, I have to say that I'm honored to be given this opportunity to join you two in holy matrimony. The words asked and spoken were here are more than just a formality. Something fundamental in your lives will change on today. The two of you came here separately, but with God's blessing, we'll be leaving hand in hand, and based upon the word of God, you indeed will be leaving here as one flesh. As of today, all the rules change. You've heard me say this 1,000 times, so I think I'll say it one more. After today, it's no longer about the I, and it will no longer be about the me. But today starts your journey where every decision that the two of you make, it will be all about the we, and not to be entered into lightly. It is a sacred covenant between a man and a woman to love each other until death do you part. Now in the presence of God and all of these witnesses, I challenge you too to do everything in your power to protect and uphold that promise to each other. But most importantly, I challenge you to make sure you uphold it to God. That's the most important thing. To make this declaration of your love here today is to recognize the seriousness with which God views marriage, and your intention is to abide in that covenant with one another. Genesis 2:24 says, therefore a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two shall be one flesh. Marriage is a union instituted not by man, it's instituted by God. And so it is only right that it begins by asking God to be present in the ceremony and in your lives. Marriage is a lifelong journey that will require a lifetime commitment to God and each other. Now that said, I'm sure you both know that marriage is not always going to be a walk in the park. But if you keep Christ first in your lives and keep him at the center of your marriage, God will give you grace to push through every season of life together. You won't be able to control every circumstance that life may throw your way. But if you hold on to each other and walk in the oneness that God will give you today and keep Christ first in your lives, you will learn to dance even in the midst of the rain. Be sure to make memories together. Laughed often when he winked. Slept. Because I did. Laugh often and be sure to help to learn creative ways, or allow God to help you to learn creative ways to build each other up instead of tearing each other down. Work together to minimize the stress around you, because there will always be stress, but if you work together to minimize it, and with the help of God, try not to be the source of each other's stress. You see, but those are the times when true love will have to step in, for true love is not a feeling, it's not an emotion, but true love is a commitment to God and a commitment to each other to do the right thing, even when it feels wrong. This is the kind of sacrificial love that God showed us by sending his son, Jesus, to die on a cross for our sins. It is that kind of love that he wants us to show each other. That is what your vows are all about. And that's what our scripture reading from 1 Corinthians 13 tells us. It gives us a clear definition of what love is and what it's not. It reads that love is patient. It reads that love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It's not self-seeking. It's not easily angered. It keeps no records of love. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. I believe that repetition is the mother of mastery. So the more you hear it, the more you'll believe it, the more you'll digest it, the more you live it. I think it's important to note that not one of those descriptive words acknowledges how we feel. But instead, it describes what love is and what love does. Christ did not feel like dying on the cross for our sins. As he said to his Father, "Take this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine will be done." And he completed the assignment. So Mark and Lauren, on today, I celebrate your new beginning with you. And I'm honored again to have this privilege to join you two as you become one flesh. But when the challenging days and nights come, and they will, I beg you with every ounce of my being, I'm telling you in front of these people, I beg you, because I know that they will come. I beg you to hold on to God tighter than you ever held on to him, even in your toughest place in life. But then I ask you also to hold on to each other tighter than you ever have. And when you do, I ask you to remember these words. Are you listening to me? Mark and Lauren, you are patient. Mark and Lauren are kind. Mark and Lauren do not envy. Mark and Lauren do not boast. Mark and Lauren are not proud. Mark and Lauren do not dishonor others. Mark and Lauren are not self-seeking. Mark and Lauren are not easily angered. Mark and Lauren keep no records of wrongdoing.
Two outside candles burning here represent your lives at this moment. Each life is distinct. Each able to go a separate way. Mark and Lauren are two persons, unique, individual human beings. And the same Father who gave each of you your individuality and uniqueness is now giving you to each other. The scriptural mystery shall be fulfilled. The two shall become one flesh. From now on, what each of you has been individually will become together. What will touch your lives as individuals will become a part of a new unity. As each of you take a candle, carry the flame to the center candle and extinguish the small candle. Thus, let the center fire represent the new unity that has been celebrated in this service. As the one center light cannot be divided, neither can your lives. May the one in whose name you are joined, who worked in your lives as individuals, continue to walk with you and your life together. May the radiance of the one light be a testimony of your unity in the Lord Jesus Christ.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And therefore I pledge you my faith.
Therefore I pledge you my faith.
Lauren, repeat these words. I, Lauren Pack.
I, Lauren Pack.
Did I listen?
I, Lauren Pack.
Okay, Pack. I want to make sure it's right. I take thee, Martiapa.
I take thee, Martiapa.
To be my wedded husband.
Be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better,
for richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and cherish.
To love and cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I pledge you my faith.
And therefore I pledge you my faith.
And from the earliest, the circle has been a symbol of wedded love. Being one unbroken circle, it symbolizes unending love. As often as either of you see these silver circles, you will be reminded of this high moment and the unending love you promised to each other before God and before men. Oh God, bless these rings that the giver and the wearer may dwell in the richness of your love, living together and growing appreciation and respect one for the other. Amen. If we can get that to Mark. Mark, take this ring and place it upon your wedding finger. Upon and repeat. Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a token.
As a token.
Of wedded love and faith.
Wedded love and faith.
Amen. Lauren, repeat these words. Take this ring. Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a token of wedded love.
As a token of wedded love.
And faith.
And
faith. And if you give me a second, I want to go sign this really quickly. I always like to sign this in the presence of their witnesses so you know it's official. So nobody will ever try anything funny. Mark and Lauren have consented together in holy wedlock and have declared the same before God and in the presence of this company. I pronounce them man and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Let us pray. It's not time to get your bride. Don't even try it. The Lord God, who created our first parents and sanctified their union in marriage, sanctify and bless you, that you may please him both in body and soul, and live together in holy matrimony until life's end. Almighty and most merciful God, who has now united Mark and Lauren in the holy state of matrimony, grant them the grace to live therein according to this holy word. Strengthen them in constant fidelity and true affection towards each other. Sustain and defend them amidst all trials and every temptation, and help them so to pass through this world in faith toward thee, in communion with thy holy church, and in the church service of one of the other, that they may enjoy forever thy heavenly benediction, through Jesus Christ our Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end. Amen. I'm going to invite you to say the Lord's Prayer with us, please. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Now receive the benediction. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rains fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may now kiss your bride. Mr. and Mrs. Mark Alden Giampa.
You're so good and pure. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, put your hands together for the man and woman of the evening out there, guys. Let's hear it for Arlen! Congratulations. Folks, kindly take your seats, make yourselves comfortable.
I heard rumors from her friends and from everyone else that they should start dating. But anything I heard from Warren was, he's just a friend. He's just a friend. I don't like him that way. And when all the blue, out of the blue, to me it seemed like, they started dating. And I couldn't put my finger on what changed until I saw Warren go up to my then boyfriend, now husband. Went up to my husband with his back turned to her and grabbed his butt. I was shocked. He was shocked. But then the light bulb clicked, and I'm like, oh, she found the butt that she wanted to squeeze for the rest of her life. I figured it out. Anyways, Connor and Mark, you were friends way before you all started dating. That is your foundation. So as times are good, lean on that friendship. When times are bad, lean into that foundation even more so. So I'm keeping it short. Cheers, Mr. and Mrs. Giamba. So, because she's my younger sister, she kind of would look up to me and follow me around. So when Mark started dating, Mark started following Mark. So if I was hanging out with Mark, I was also hanging out with Mark. And so we were just kind of like a trio type of deal. We'd be at soccer games and stuff like that. But Mark was always just there. He was kind of quiet. There were a couple events that happened that really like Mark's part of him. The first one I technically wasn't present for, but I heard about, and I'm not gonna be mean and embarrass you in front of everybody. But it was an incident down in Richmond, Virginia, and if you know, you know. They know. But everybody felt like he was really part of the family. And then for me specifically, John was a huge Chevy as an older brother than I ever had. And so I moved a few times and John was always there. And then when I moved to my most recent place, I needed help. And Mark stepped up and helped me out, helped me pick out furniture and bring it back. And that really meant a lot to Mark. So before I completely lose it, after my voice is starting to shake, Mark, you've always been so steady for Lauren and have always been the one person to be what she needed. We all know Lauren can be a little difficult. But if there's anybody in this world to be her rock, it's you. I'm very much so appreciative. I've always been there for her when she's needed it. And just keep doing that. Again, like, you know, I've seen you go through work some challenges, and you guys are here today, and you guys have one of the strongest loves that I've seen. So, raise your glasses to Mr. and Mrs. Jim.
Lauren, it is with great honor and pleasure at this time I'd like to give you a beautiful opportunity, man, to share a dance with the first man in your life out there, your wonderful father tonight, Mr. David, if you will, sir.
There's two things I know for sure. Should I send here from heaven?
Opportunity to share a dance with the first woman that ever put up with you in life. Your beautiful mother out there. Miss Lisa, if you will, ma'am. One more time, put your hands together for Miss Lisa and Mr. Mark out there. Sir, how long have you and your beautiful wife been married?
59 years, ladies and gentlemen.
Let's hear it for one time. I love the young lady.
I don't cry when it rains no more, or I get dirt on my shoes. I don't mind climbing 8 more floors, 'cause these stairs are all heading to you. like a glove. And tell the band to play one more slow song, 'cause you still have all my love. One more cold drink, one more road, one more dance before the doors get closed. Please remember, enjoy the show. Let's get happy before we get old.
Round of applause for your newlyweds out there, guys. Mark and Mark, putting that beautiful wedding cake tonight. Let's see you guys. Come on. Let's get happy before we get old.